morning, everybody, and welcome to Timberland City United Methodist Church. I'm delighted that you're here. This is our third service today at our Front Porch Gospel at 8 o'clock. We had the Ignite Youth Choir at the 9:15 service, and now for our 10:30 service, we will also have the Ignite Youth Choir. And another thing I want to mention just before we introduce them and get started is some of you know, but probably not everyone knows, that each summer we have a youth mission team who actually just make this their base of operations. They come basically camp out in our building for the week, do some projects around the area, and this year they dedicate one day to doing projects for us. They did a deep cleaning on our kitchen that is just amazing. And that needed to happen, incidentally. You know how you just keep using a kitchen like that? And that they did. By the way, nice thank you card from them for us hosting them. Let me share this card with you real quick, all right? And it says this: thank you for opening up your church to us. This has become a second home for many of us and is our absolute favorite trip to take. This place is such a huge blessing to us all year round. It gives us one last opportunity to pour into our graduates before they leave for college. Also gives us an opportunity to pour into our incoming seniors as they prepare to take on their leadership role for the next year. We're in prayer over you and your congregation. May God rain down blessings on you all. And this is from the Christ Church Teams 2022. So we appreciate them. It was awesome having them here this week, getting to host them. And even more cool than that is having the Ignite Youth Choir here one more round today. I know they've got it in. They're a little bit tired and worn out from they've been on tour, you know. And like a rock band, they just go on tour. And we're on the last leg of this tour. And so we greatly appreciate that. So what I'm going to invite you to do is this. We're going to pray together, and then we're going to extend them a big welcome, all right? Let's pray first. Our God, we take this moment right now to seek your presence. We know that each person here has needs today. God, we just want to lift them up to you. The person who came here with questions and doubts, Lord, that you would bring them answers and some assurance today. The one who came in today who is in need of encouragement, God, that they would find that. And Lord, that each one here would just be blessed with the overwhelming sense of your love and presence in our lives. And then, God, we hold up to you each one in this choir and their families and loved ones, that you would bless them in their travel. Lord, that you would just put a mighty anointing of your Holy Spirit on the music they bring today, that each of us here would sense that anointing and know that you're present and speaking to us and working in our lives. And more than anything else, God, that the young people who are singing today would know that as well. And they would have the confidence that it's not just them, but they are working together with the Holy Spirit guiding and using them every second of this time. And so, God, we ask that you just inhabit the praises of your people in this place today. And for this, we give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. And now let's welcome the Ignite Youth Choir.
Thank you. Christ is our one true light that shines in our darkness. Let this program be a reminder that our beacon of hope and grace through Jesus Christ is a gift to be shared all throughout the year.
Through the
certain, Jesus is the light in the darkness. He is our hope. He is our answer to every problem.
Oh,
come see you walk in tower strength. Even when life is raging, His mercy is new. Let the morning dew at every trial's end. There's never been another power like this. Never will there ever again.
Thank you. guys tell us all the time, and we appreciate it, how blessed you are that we are here. And we are blessed to be here. But I am blessed every week to hear these guys and be in ministry with them. And I'm going to clap for them again. I'm going to continue. So, for those of you that don't know, we are in our eighth season. We have 1 week left in our season, and it was just 8-ish, 9-ish years ago, right? Debbie Canio had been directing another middle school group in town, and my youngest daughter, who has already aged out of this group, wanted to be in it, and we didn't hear anything about it starting or anything like that, and I ran into Debbie at the grocery store and said, "Hey, is our group going to get started?" And I didn't know that she had left and the group was not sure they were going to keep going and all that. Turns out they weren't going to keep going, so I said, "Hey, how would you like to start this new group with me at our church?" And Ignite was born. And we had, 18 in that first year? And we came to Branson with 15 singers, I think. We had 26 at the height of this weekend. We've lost a couple of over the last couple of days, but it's been such a blessing to have Debbie and Jim as part of our ministry for 8 years to get us started, get us going. And another fun fact, my wife Susan and I celebrated our 30th anniversary this summer. It gets better. She's pregnant. No, I'm just kidding. She just left. No. That's what happens when you don't get enough sleep at a hotel. So 30 years ago, Debbie sang at our wedding. Do you remember what song you sang? Susan, do you remember what song she sang? No? I don't remember either. I just remember it was beautiful. It was great. So we've been friends for over 30 years, and the only reason we come to Branson is so we can come here and sing for you guys. So we're going to have Debbie come up and direct Go Light Your World. It's a song that she picked out for us. It's our theme song. We sing it every performance, and we close every performance with it. Carter's going to introduce it for us, and then Debbie's going to come up and direct Go Light Your World. Carter, you're up.
Thank you all for having us here today. We've sung about Jesus being the light in our darkness. Now it's up to you to take that light into the world. Be the beacon of hope and grace Christ has called us to be. The lyrics to our last song, Go Light Your World, are in your program. Please sing along.